so thanks for meeting with me today. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Good. So, first off, I wanted to give you some affirming feedback and a shout out. I know that the last couple weeks, the things we've been practicing in year 03 has been marking the paper specifically with tallies, and then last week we practiced specifically with initials. And in every observation I've come to see you in over the last couple of weeks, I've seen evidence of that on your CFS packet after you've done your agonal loops. What like impact do you think that's had on like your instruction or like your ability to identify misconceptions?
It's been really helpful, especially like times I might feel like the majority of the class doesn't have it, but then when I look at my paper, I'm like, oh, it's just these five. And it gives me like a quick look at like what I need to be doing instead, whether it's just checking in with those few kids or like putting the correct work out there.
Definitely. Yeah, I agree. I think there's a tendency a lot of times to be like, oh my gosh, no one understands this, but then you look and it's like, oh, it's actually only like three or four kids. And then you can like figure out like, how should I best address that? So really good job with that. Continue to do that like in all of your classes, it looks great. So I want us to continue today. We're still gonna be talking about AGMO and specifically like what we're going to be like layering on in addition to the work that we've already done. So I know this week in huddle, the two things that we've kind of pushed in the 7 and 8 building have been labeling AGMO rounds as well as stating like what you're looking for as you walk around the room. And when I observe you in your classroom, you're doing that about like 75-80% of the time. So like almost all of the time. So we're gonna layer on that next thing today. And to do that, I've actually pulled up a video of your class that I took on Monday. And so we're gonna take a look at this video, and what I want you to specifically look for is to describe like to me, like after you watch this, like what the pacing of your AGMO like looks like. So think specifically about pacing. Pull this up. So you just set the timer. So what are some things you noticed about the pacing, your pathway, anything like that?
So the pacing was definitely pretty slow and a little slower than what I usually do too. I remember Jesse, this was like the second or third class he was sent down, so I did a check in with him. I think the first girls were like on the wrong page of the packet.
Mm-hmm.
So there's like a few things that was like letting me slow it down. But then I think I kind of like kept at that pace, like even like Fizza when she had it incorrect, like instead of just like circling it and saying like, look here, I like spent the time like explaining it. And so the impact was, I can't tell if Jocelyn was like on task or not, but she definitely wasn't working with her partner. So it led to like her not being on task with her partner.
Yeah, for sure. So I hear you saying like it's one slower than like you've done before, because I've definitely seen you like get through like a loop pretty quickly. And there were like several barriers that you kind of named that kept you from like getting around to like the entire class. I think in like that minute that you set the timer before, you got about halfway around there. What are some of those barriers that you usually run into that like are like prevent you from doing like a full loop or like going like as quick with your AGMO as you'd like?
I'd say students behaviorally, like, so if their head's down or if, like, they've been consistently, like, off task, then I, like, that's one thing that, like, can eat up, like, a half of the time that is on the timer. And I think too, also like knowing my students, or like students with questions, like I caught myself doing that today, where like instead of being able to check everyone and then be able to explain it at the end, I explained the same thing like 3 times to people. So I think like setting that norm with students that like, hey, right now I'm gonna be collecting data and then I'm gonna be addressing the misconception, like whole group.
That makes sense, yeah. So I hear you saying a couple of things. I think like behavior, like for instance, Jesse kind of had his head down. He's having some sort of like rough day. Other students like having questions. And then I think you named like before, like Fizza like had the wrong answer. And so you kind of like stopped to like, almost like instead of just like prompting her, like kind of stopped and more so like explained it to her. So those are like a few things that I noticed as well. And so if you had to take a guess as to what we want to practice today, what would you say that we're going to be practicing?
Probably like, because since we've been emphasizing like having exactly what we're looking for in the misconceptions in our ACMO, like going around and like doing the quick, like, here's where it's wrong, try this, and like the quick redirects from base.
Absolutely. So I think you nailed it. I think it's like the quick prompts, like specifically the what that we're going to focus on, and you can write this down. The what we're going to focus on is like speed of ACMO, and the how, and you kind of already like highlighted this, is like, one, we know what our look for is, like we have our rounds and our look for, so that I would say that's like the first thing. The second thing is those quick prompts. So those are going to be the things that we kind of chunk into our practice today. So like speed of ACMO, and then specifically through what are the rounds, stating that look for kids so they're like super clear, and then what prompts are we going to use for like a variety of different things. Not just kids who have their hands up, not just kids who have their heads down, not just kids who like don't have the correct answer. And so how we're going to set up practice today is the first part of it's actually going to be a little bit of pre-work, stuff that you would actually do before you went into your lesson. So I have student work that's around the room. Before we jump into actually ACMOing, I want us to go through like what are the steps we should take before we go into the classroom to figure out our look fors, and then to plan out what prompts we think we're going to use for misconceptions or for like kids who have questions.
Okay?
So you've got your CFS in front of you, and I pulled it specifically from this exact same lesson that I videotaped. So take a look at these first two questions, and if you had to kind of chunk this into specific look fors as you're ACMOing, how would you chunk what you're looking for in this problem specifically?
For the first one, I'd say like, do they have the correct formula written down?
I like how you circled that too.
And then next, I would look for, did they substitute it incorrectly? And then honestly, probably from there, especially since they've got calculators, then I'd probably check for the answer.
Absolutely, I agree with you 100%. So I see like kind of like three rounds, like, because we know on math, they're not gonna get the formula, so I like that you made that your first round. Second round, substitution, third round, like final answer. Absolutely. And I see you kind of like did the same thing there. So I think that's what you're specifically looking for in terms of as you ACMO. What do you think, if you had to anticipate a misconception on either of these problems, who I already see you circle something, what do you think that misconception would be for either of those?
For the first one, like just from times in the past, students not squaring this, or like adding 4 and 4. So I'd probably look somewhere around there, for the misconception. And then obviously for misconception for like creating the formula, like doing height over 3, or something like that. And then for the second one, the biggest thing to look for is that they're having the diameter, and having the radius be 1.5. So on that second round, I'd really be looking just to see that they've got that 1.5 in.
Definitely. So let's kind of like pause there and like stamp what we just did, so that you can like take this and implement it into like every lesson. So what was like the first thing that we kind of did as we were like thinking about how we were going to chunk this?
So first we looked at what are the rounds, like what are specific pieces that I'm looking for. And then next we looked like what are potential areas that students might make a mistake that we could highlight.
Awesome. Do you want to write that down real quick?
Yep.
So now you have your rounds, you have them on your CFS packet as well. And this is going to allow you to like AGMO pretty efficiently. We are gonna practice like what's gonna happen like if a kid has their head down, what's gonna happen if a kid's not showing work. But one thing that we'll also practice like before we jump into the AGMO is if a kid has incorrect work on their paper. And so I know that you named with Fizza that she had the incorrect work and you kind of stopped and explained. Let's use number two as an example. Let's say that she didn't do this correctly. She used the diameter of 3 instead of the radius of 1.5. What's a quick prompt that you could use to really quickly highlight the error and tell her like what to do?
So one is I could identify like we need to find our radius. Where do we see our radius in the problem? Or I could go directly at the problem and say like it's saying widest part, is that gonna equal our radius or diameter?
Definitely. And what I like that you specifically did is you circled it. So I think like the non-negotiables is like circle where she's gonna find the information and then tell her specifically in her equation like where to look. So that's a prompt that you could use as like you're circulating for kids who have incorrect work. So we've got our rounds, we know what misconceptions we're probably gonna have, and you have at least one prompt that you can use to identify that misconception. So what I wanna practice right now is we're not gonna jump immediately into those prompts. I want us to do one practice round where we're just getting in the hang of stating what you're looking for, and then just getting back in like the rhythm of like going through that full pathway. Sound good?
Yep.
All right, so I'm gonna have you go to the front of the room. Set your turn and talk direction, name what you're looking for, and then do your full AGMO loop, and then we're gonna like increase the complexity like in the next rounds.
All right. All right, team, we're gonna take 2 minutes on soft voices with our partner on section number one. I'm looking that you're setting up that correct formula and substituting in the current values. 2 minutes, soft voices, go ahead. Larry and Henry immediately jumped into that turn and talk, but Isla's got the pencil up in a movement. And then should I like do like one round just checking the formula and then go back and do like an actual physical second loop, or should I check all three at the same time?
Based on your kid's work, what do you think would be the most practical?
Maybe group the first two together and then go on to the third.
I think so. I think after you go through that first row, you can check for formulas. By the time you get to this point, kids should be at the substitution part and you probably want to group them together.
Okay.
Yep. So let's start from like right there. Good, good pace. Really good job getting those tallies down for incorrect work.
Well, he's doing a really strong job showing every single step of that work.
Good academic narration.
Larry substituted in that value for his radius.
Yes. Yes. As you're circulating, make sure to pick your eyes up to scan the rest of the room. Yep.
Should I do my second, or?
Awesome, so let's pause there.
Okay.
How'd that feel?
Good.
Let me check here. Yep, absolutely. Oh, nice, there were only, all of them. There were only 3 incorrect, so you actually got all 3 of the ones that were incorrect. So what I want you to do this time now is as you're going through and you see those 3 incorrect responses, and let's specifically focus on question number 2. You see those 3 quick responses, let's now loop in how you're gonna prompt those students to fix their error.
Okay.
And remember like still minimizing the amount of talk time and then like getting through the rest of that loop. So start from the beginning again.
All right, team, we're gonna take 2 minutes soft voices with your partner on section one. I'm looking for you to write in that correct format and to show those values that you're substituting in. 2 minutes soft voices with your partner, go ahead.
Nice.
Angela Bryson immediately got to talking. Chloe's got the pencil up and put.
Really good job with those look fours.
Good. what does it mean when we're trying to find the widest friend?
Good, yeah, very quick. That took like less than 2 seconds for you to say.
Keep showing your work. So seeing that strong work from Larry and Henry, you both have something different in for that. Talk about what it means to have a widest friend.
Good prompt, especially using like the partner to like help out. Awesome. Make sure to pick up those eyes. Yep, good.
Chloe and do you still have enough strong dream talk? We both have different answers. Why do you think he has 1.5? Make sure you keep showing all of that work. What does that mean? Let's talk about the widest word.
Awesome. So one thing that you did really well is you actually kind of combined the rounds that I was going to do. You started circling kids who weren't showing full work, which is going to be like another prompt
awesome.
That you can like definitely use. That was really quick. How did that feel in terms of pacing?
Really good. I think one thing, I don't know, you said this, but I like get very varied in like what I'm looking for. So I think like looking around the room is definitely something I could work on as I'm going.
Right, and I think it's kind of like you're gonna have that like spidey sense go off. Like I haven't looked at my room in a while. I want to make sure Jocelyn in the middle of the room is still like on task. So that's why I kind of gave you those quick redirects. Like, hey, pick those eyes up. Let's do one more round. And what I want you to do specifically in this one is same exact thing with your AGMO. And I'm gonna pretend to be a student who has a question.
Okay.
And so I want you to kind of go off the cuff and think about like how would I redirect that student. If they have a question, because I know that you already have said, like, sometimes I answer those before I get around to, like, every single kid, and then I go over it anyway, like, whole
group.
Okay? So, let's start again.
All right, so we're going to take 2 minutes soft voices with your partner on section one. I'm looking for you to write that correct formula down, and for you to substitute in those correct values. 2 minutes soft voices, go ahead. Jocelyn and Leland immediately got to talking. Jesse and Adrian have the pencil up and moving. Go on to the next problem, I'll come around the second.
Good.
Check for the widest part. Make sure you're showing all of that work. Check what does it mean when it says the widest part. Make sure you're showing your work just like your teammate. So your workbook's going right here. Check what does it mean when it says the widest part. If you're still stuck, we're gonna go over it in a second.
Good. Let's pause right there. Nice job. That was like really quick in how you answered my like whatever like that question might have been. And you kind of like redirected me in the same exact way that you would redirect a student who like had the incorrect answer. So I think that was really effective. So let's sit down really quick. Nice job. Way to crank that up. So I know we've got a class coming in here in like a couple minutes. So I just want to see next steps. So I know that you have a few things written down here. If you wanted to like summarize what we went over today and what I'm going to be looking for. When I come to your classroom next, what do you think those things are going to be?
I think the first thing is to go over the CFS packet before class and make sure
yes.
I have those rounds and misconceptions down for each section. And then while I'm actually going over them, and this is something I could also include in the CFS packet, is to see like what are my redirects going to be for mm-hmm. those misconceptions.
Definitely. Absolutely. And then so that's like all the pre-work. So I'm really glad that you bucketed into like this actually, a majority of what we did today was actually before we even jumped into the role play. In class, what do you think I'm gonna be looking for as a AGMO?
The pacing mm-hmm. of my AGMO, making sure I'm still writing down those initials or tallies, and mm-hmm. then to redirect students quickly if they've got a question or
definitely. And like when I'm in there, like you can expect me to give like live feedback on you as well. Like you might, I might just be like do like a motion like this, be like, oh, I need to like leave the student go and quickly like get the rest of my data. I'll also probably be going hip to hip with you on a lot of it, like we already do. So I will be in your room next Wednesday. I know I have an observation scheduled for you then. No, next Tuesday. So that's gonna be the stuff that I look for.
Cool.
Nice job today.
Thank you.
Thank you.